Hello everyone. In this video, I will show you the simple steps to password protect your external SSD or USB flash drive on macOS Sonoma. However, you can still follow along even using older versions such as Ventura, Monterey, or Big Sur. In any case, securing your data such as financial statements, work-related documents, family photos, and private messages is crucial. In brief, protect your valuable data today to avoid any future regrets. Let's get started. The first step towards encrypting your disk with a password is to connect your external SSD or hard disk drive to your Mac. If you cannot see your external drive icon on the desktop, click anywhere on your desktop. Next, navigate to the Finder menu and select Settings or Preferences. Then click on the General tab and ensure that the External Disks option is selected. In this tutorial, I am using a Samsung T7. The following step is crucial. If you have any data on your external device, make sure to copy it to your desktop or another location before encrypting your drive. All data will be permanently erased in the encryption process. In the following step, click the Spotlight icon in the menu, type Disk Utility, and click its icon to launch it. Once you have launched the Disk Utility, click View and select Show All Devices from the drop-down menu. A list of all connected drives will appear on the left-hand side. Locate your external SSD or hard drive from this list and make sure to select the correct one to avoid any accidental data loss. Your external drive will be listed under External, and your internal drive above it. To format your external drive, select it by clicking the first drive at the top. Then click the Erase button in the toolbar. In the name field, I enter Protected SSD. You can enter any name you like. Next, I will click the Format pop-up menu and select APFS Encrypted. Why APFS? APFS, Apple File System, is used by macOS 10.13 and later. It is optimized for SSDs and flash drives. Since I want to put a password on my SSD, I will select APFS Encrypted. APFS also works on hard disk drives. If you are using a modern version of macOS such as Sonoma, Ventura, or Monterey and don't need compatibility with older system, then APFS is the recommended option. If you own an older Mac running an operating system version 10.12 or earlier, you may not be able to use the APFS format. In such cases, you can choose macOS Extended Journal Encrypted. This format is compatible with older Mac systems, enabling you to use your external storage device with your older Mac. I will now enter my password and then enter it again to confirm it. If you want to check the strength of your password, click on the key icon. If the color is red, it indicates a weak password. Therefore, I will make my password stronger until the color changes to green. I have changed my password and the quality indicator shows green, meaning proceeding is safe. Remember to write down your password and keep it in a secure place. You can leave the password hint empty or enter anything you want. For example, I love tomatoes, and then click choose. Next, choose GUID partition map from the scheme pop-up menu and click erase. The erasing process has been completed, so I will click Done. I can now copy my files and folders to the volume. To eject it, I will right-click and select Eject. If you are finding value and learning something new from my videos, please subscribe. Your subscriptions inspire me to create more content that matters to you. Thank you. The next time I connect my SSD to my Mac, I'll have to enter my password to access its content. Here is a helpful tip. Whenever you delete a file or a folder by dragging it to the trash, make sure to empty the trash. If you skip this step, the file will remain on your device, even if you eject the volume. So let's go ahead and eject it. As you can see, the trash is currently empty. Next, I will open my SSD and then the trash. You may be surprised to find the same file reappearing in the trash. To free up more space on your device, empty the trash before ejecting the volume. Here is the second tip. If you decide to restore your file or folder, right-click on it and from the context menu select Put Back. I suggest keeping backups in two different locations by investing in another SSD or USB flash drive in case you lose your drive or accidentally erase your files. Another option is to use a cloud service for added security and accessibility. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on the LT Lucid Tutorials logo and sharing the video link with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.